Oi, you there. That's enough of that. Coming a regular this, Nick Ellis. What's this time, Fred?
Howling outside the old lady, muttering about a murder in Threadneedle Street, cursing insects on the National Railroad. Had to bring her in, didn't I?
Chant minutes to herself. But no danger to others, surely. She don't belong in jail.
Too true, but where then does she belong?
Let's walk her out, Fred. Send her back to Dr. Bambi. He raised holy hell last time I kept her overnight.
Oh, what happened?
Same night Jack splattered at the waste of mother's love was nabbed for gutting that heavy outside a mermaid. Yeah, I was taking Alice down and we meet two coppers walking Jack to the cells. He's mad in the usual I'd never wrong bloke nonsense. When he sees Addie yells, she screams, you miserable cur, you leech, you maggot, living off another's labour, etc., etc. I'm admiring her line of inquiry, but suddenly she hits her head or something and faints. Couldn't send her home, could I?
And Dr. Bumby pitched a fit.
Said he'd have me jobbing me arse on a plate. Told him he could have the former. Leave the latter alone, thank you very much. Good night, Alice. You know the way out.
Charges.
This is my day off.
What's she done this time?
Indecent exposure. Cockfighting. Abusive language.
Sign out if you can.
Thank you. Claimed I'd stolen his heart, trifling with his affections. Creepy sort. Touching me. Tell Papa to never invite him to tea again.
Thank you. Light is useless if what it illuminates causes pain and suffering. Better to cast such things into the dark depths of Lethe, the river of forgetfulness.
Thank you.
Back to admire your handiwork, returning to the scene of the crime.
It had to be done, Cat. You said so yourself. You and this Red Queen cannot both survive. She is a cancer in your body. Excise her or perish.
Well, she was the face of evil in the heart of darkness.
She didn't treat you too well last time, lost your head as I recall.
She was completely deranged. You picked up her crown, but now you've put it down. You must speak to her, what's left of her anyway.
I do support the monarchy, in principle. I'm sure the Queen is very good at what she does, whatever that is. But is she not a person, just like ourselves?
Alice, I know your fondness for all manner of puzzles. What comes next in the sequence? 1, 3, 4, 7, 11. You're correct, miss.
Thank you.
The Red Kingdom's in ruins, but you're no better off.
When you defeated her, I tried to reclaim the castle, but I was set upon by her monstrosities. The malignant royal bitch still reigns.
I'm here to petition her. I must get inside.
The only way in is through me. Sacrifices must be made.
Those who say so usually mean they should be made by others.
Cynicism is a disease. It can be cured. Once inside, beware of the outsized killer who patrols her domain. Never confront him. He is invincible. Now cut me loose. I'll show you the meaning of sacrifice.
Games, too, require hard choices. Unpleasant sacrifices must often be made to accomplish a desired goal.
Picture tells a story. You wouldn't tolerate a book without pictures when you were a girl.
Thank you. bearskin rug before the hearth, no deer antlers on the wall, no taxidermic abominations in the house, demeans the creature's dignity.
Idiot. Don Quixote had a better chance with his windmill, and without risk of decapitation.
A prudent exit is no less so for being hasty. A weapon's intended function is almost beside the point. Ultimately, it's only as good as the person who wields it.
Queen's Guardian rarely leaves his filthy lair, but you're special.
Thank you.
privilege to decapitate intruders only at your peril.